Hey people, welcome to my top 25 supernatural anime. I understand and aware that there are perhaps a lot more better shows out there, however I unfortunately haven't watched all the supernatural anime out there in existence, so my sincere apologies for not watching enough to your own personal liking. So smack that like button now, and let the video commence. Nono Exorcist demonstrates that you can still tell a decent story if you don't follow the main adaptation. The show pretty much falls into your cliche shonens with the twist of throwing in exorcism and all sorts of spirits and demons about for those who like that sort of stuff sprinkled into your typical supernatural anime. The show has a lot of potential to branch much further, however due to lack of material to adapt, it was left to the studio A1 Pictures to fill in the holes and come up with their own story, which I really liked towards the second half. As for the first half, I just found it quite slow and pretty to look at. Personally, I would like to see Nono Exorcist given a second chance, especially as the manga is pretty interesting and I felt that the anime didn't particularly tap into that potential whatsoever. Nanana's buried treasure for sure exceeded my expectations for what I had thought of it firsthand. The storyline for this show is the big hook, as it should be for every anime. What Nanana's buried treasure does is create these adventures and mysteries to get you coming back for more and more episodes, as each dungeon that our characters approach bring out the adventure that we scarcely don't get from anime set in a modern day setting. In contrast, you only get adventure coming from fantasy anime nowadays. The plot revolves around Jugo, the new guy with hidden mysteries at the start that eventually unravel. Throughout the anime, you'll see him confront certain people from his past. Once pursuing the treasures of Nanana's buried treasure, they each hold a significant power that enable people to essentially walk over anyone. The characters here are definitely intriguing, especially the protagonist who doesn't fall into the cliche setup of being either too overpowered, nor weak, or stupid, nor abnormally intelligent. Nanana's the heroine of the series is even more of a mystery and likes to keep it that way, which is quite the fun tease throughout the entirety of the show. Unfortunately for Nanana, she is unable to rest in peace after her murder from 10 years ago. Therefore, she leaves it to Jugo and this adventurous club to go seek out her collection. The genres that this anime is listed are completely misleading, as it's just listed as a rom-com with a supernatural genre thrown into the mix. However, I don't recommend this show whatsoever if you are looking for a romantic comedy, as the show deters away from that very much. This long-winded named anime is one of the few examples of an anime that a studio got for the sake of just adapting with no sights on a sequel. Why? Well, Mondachi has an interesting concept with much unexplored potential given the fact there are only 10 episodes. Some may argue that this makes Mondachi all the more appealing to those repellent to anime. However, I personally believe that's debatable, as another 2 or 3 episodes would definitely be used for the show to hit its peak, like with most anime. But anyway, that concludes that rant. The anime has an interesting world set out for our main characters. Isayoi, the overpowered badass, Asuka, the girl with the gift of authority, then this cute girl, Yu, then we have Kurosaki, the eye candy, and perhaps the second most strongest character that you'll see in the anime. The three main protagonists are drawn to this world from their own retrospective timelines to save this community, to overthrow the Devil King, who is the biggest, powerful, strongest being in this world. The way each battle is settled through here in this show is through a game, quite like No Game No Life, where you must also wager their territory to the victor. The world is made up of 7 layers, and so the closer you are to gate 1, which is right in the middle here, the stronger you ideally should be, and even furthermore, each layer is also split into 4 sectors, in north, east, south, and west. But to sum up, this show will most definitely get you invested in the fun battles ahead, and will make you gape at Isayoi's endless strength. If you're looking for an anime for a casual watch that provides that escapism to a fantasy world with games, powers, and challenges, then Mondaichi will not disappoint. Noragami is an anime that had high anticipation from most anime fans, as the show was animated by good old Bones Studio. The show is an adaptation of the manga, and from what I hear, the anime took its own course towards the end. However, I don't believe that this impacted the anime in such a way where the show can't carry on with the sequel. The story itself is most enjoyable with its comedy that Yato brings to the show, and of course, the serious moments where you feel sympathy for Yukine as his character demonstrates the pain of being forgotten in this world as a spirit who serves as a weapon for our main guy Yato, the god of war. Well, a god of calamity. He scrawls his number in bathrooms, informing people that he's a delivery god who will accept almost any service in exchange for a measly 5 yen, which Yato seems to over-exaggerate its worth. We then have our other main heroine, Hiyori, who starts off as a normal girl who can exit out of her body as a soul on demand whilst leaving her actual body lying unconscious in a coma state, causing all sorts of misunderstandings. Overall, Noragami has an interesting world, but the show itself feels restricted in the way of being held back by a measly 12 episodes. Bloodlad was one of my favourite seinen seen is that unfortunately only had a shot at a good 10 episodes, but anime has an interesting fun cast of random creatures of all sorts, ranging from vampires to demons to werewolves, ghosts, and many more. Bloodlad plays into the cliche and makes a mockery of shonens, which comes into a surprise as it's actually a seinen. The story is about Stas, a vampire boss who wants to resurrect a human girl who has become a ghost. Through this adventure, we get an insight to both characters' past and see developments occur along with the interesting world that Stas comes from. The characters are quite enjoyable as they each have their own different personalities from the other that complements the atmosphere we have with this setup. Bloodlad itself will not disappoint you with its length, as you'll reach a conclusion and feel content with how it's ended with no cliffhangers, except for one that will encourage you, the viewer, to pursue the manga full. And if you want to see the rest of my thoughts, check out my Bloodlad review. I hope you found at least one show that tickled your fancy. If not, let me know down below some of your favourite supernatural anime, and heck, even I will consider checking out your suggestions. Please slap on that like button before you depart, and here are the rest of the parts to my top supernatural anime.